It's great. I always enjoy going to conventions. I've just spent 4 weeks going around the world, meeting fans in Australia and America, Aruba. Yeah, it's great. I love it.
It's a very exciting time for Whovians at the moment with our next doctor, and not only a new doctor, but our first female doctor in Jodie Whittaker. I'm sure the obvious question fans will have, what are your feelings about that, about our first female doctor, and also about Jodie specifically as a fit for the role?
Well, I mean, before it happened, I was uncertain about it, really. But now that it's been announced, I think, actually, it's quite exciting, it's quite interesting, it's fascinating to see what happens. When I heard, I sent her an email, or no, Facebook, or Twitter. A Twitter it was. I sent her a Twitter and said, congratulations, and one small step for woman, one great leap for womankind. And I think it's really now very good. You know, it's broken through a glass ceiling. Eccentricity, I think, is one of the... I think the actor's got to have a natural eccentricity. I'm afraid I don't really know Jodie's work very well because I don't see a lot of television. I've been travelling a hell of a lot. And so I can't comment on that. I can only trust that the people who've chosen her are very, very experienced and know what they're doing. So I wish her well, and I'd be fascinated to see how it goes, really. When every time there's a new doctor, there's always controversy. But this is quite a dramatic change, so it's even more controversial, which in a way makes it interesting. If I were her, my advice to her would be learn your lines and try to bump into the monsters.
We're saying goodbye at the same time to Peter. What did you make of his tenure as the Doctor? I think obviously fans, very sad to see him go, and I think very appreciative of the work that he did during his time in that blue police box.
He was great. He is great. He's wonderful. And I enjoyed the fact that it was an older Doctor again. I thought that was very important because although, Matt and David were wondrous and brought a whole new kind of light to the Doctor. For me, I thought it would be really good for society to have a Superman or a hero who's older. Because in Western, well, especially Anglo-Saxon society, we don't treat our old as the way we should treat them. So for young people to grow up respecting an older Doctor is very important. So I hope that after Jodie, we might have an older, perhaps another woman. Miriam Margolis, I think, would be great as the next Lady Doctor. Although I wouldn't like to be in the TARDIS with her because she farts a lot. I know what I want to say. My fans nag Netflix to allow Sense8 to continue. Especially now, it's a program about various genders of humanity and a loving portrayal of them. And it's very important, especially now that we have such a lowlife in the high office who's come out and banned, transgender people in the military in America. It's very important we keep that going because people are ignorant of it, and I perfectly understand that, but once they watch Sense8, they get to see how other people live and appreciate them. Ignorance is what's wrong, and Sense8 is educational in that sense. Working with the Wachowskis was quite a joy, really. The Lana, I didn't meet the other sister, but I met Lana, and who directed it, and she was great, great sense of humour. great warmth, and of course, imagination. And, you know, watching her work as a director is quite fascinating. She's part of the camera, in a way, behind the cameraman, behind directing, changing, improvising. It's great. Well, I'm starting rehearsing on Tuesday for a play I'm doing at the Edinburgh Festival called A Joke with Bob Picardo from Star Trek and various other things. Well known. He's a hologram doctor, I think. Star Trek Voyager. So we're working together with them. Christopher Oliver, and the three of us, and it's called A Joke, an Englishman, an Irishman, and a Scotsman. And it's all about humour. That's the next thing. And I'm waiting for a film I did earlier called Slumber, which is a horror film, where I get to foam at the mouth, bounce off the walls, and try and kill children. Great fun.